You have been quite outspoken on the Qatar situation. You actually wrote an op-ed calling Qatar the architect of its own isolation. So explain to us what you think needs to happen in order to resolve this impasse.
Yeah, good morning. I think there's the only one solution. They have Qatar, unfortunately, the ruler of Qatar, Hamad bin Khalifa, and his family promised and signed an agreement to not to support any terrorism or to support the Brotherhood or Hamas or Hezbollah and this. But unfortunately, this was in the air. Nothing has been happened, and all their promises is did not implemented. Therefore, as I said in my article, the only solution, and you know, enough is enough from the promises and politics and diplomacy between the brothers in the GCC. I mean, that is the mistake. We are a lot. We are good people, and we think the other people will be better. So the only solution, in my opinion, as I stated in my article, Hamad bin Khalifa and his family, his wife and children, plus Hamad bin Jassim, should leave the country and should go to any country in the world, because they have billions and billions of dollars. Every country will welcome them, but they have to be very careful not to support terrorism. There's Al Thani family. They have a big family, over 5,000 people, and they have good people on that side, and they can choose some of them, and there's a lot of opposition. They can rule, and we can be, you know, together as a family, GCC will come back, and we can trust them. But if they stay, whatever the agreement they do, it will not be to our benefit, and I don't trust it, and we should not waste our time to that.